So, Dr. Cabral, around 700,000 school children were vaccinated with this vaccine back in 2016 in that 3.5 billion peso program of the government. Mm. There have been critics who say that some deaths have been linked to the vaccine.
Yes, right.
Well, that is not proven yet.
Not at
all. We leave that to
yes.
other, I mean, to the courts, for the courts to decide. Would we at least admit that there was something wrong in the administration of this vaccine in the past?
Not wrong. Maybe mm-hmm. they could have done it a little better than the way they did it, but I'm not sure that we can say that it was wrong. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure that we can impute corruption or greed into the picture. I think it was a judgment call by the previous administration, and they did what they thought was the best thing to do at the time.
Mm-hmm. So, ma'am, because I think the confusion there started coming in when mm-hmm. we suddenly found out, wow, this vaccine is only for those who
yes.
have been infected by dengue. And
correct.
We don't know
yes.
how many of the 700,000 school children have actually been infected by dengue.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody tested. Nobody probably even asked.
Well, we have not tested individually, but in many surveys that have been done by government and by outside scientists in the Philippines, they have found that after the age of 9, nearly 85% of people in the Philippines have had one type of dengue or another. And that after the age of 12, more than 95% of us have had at least one dengue infection. So you can actually say that the vast majority of people after the age of 12 have had dengue, whether they realize it or not, whether they have had the symptom or not. Because only one out of every four people with a dengue infection actually develop symptoms and find out that they have dengue. Mm-hmm.
So you think that, I mean, the judgment call mm-hmm. makes sense from a professional's perspective?
Yes,
from your perspective.
It is a judgment call. And the judgment call is something that you need to allow the people who are doing the judgment call for us.
And even without the test, because
yes,
the World Health Organization
even without saying, the test.
Because we could take the ELISA test to check for a serial.
Unfortunately, the tests that we have are not perfect either, mm-hmm. the blood tests, okay? There are tests that will tell you that you have an acute episode of dengue. Mm-hmm. But if you had dengue 2 years ago, for example, and you did a blood test, it may not show that you have had dengue from the current tests mm-hmm. that we have.
Mm-hmm. So, ma'am, now your group, of course, you're not, you're retired already, but you are part of this group of doctors.
Yes, I'm a member of Doctors mm-hmm. for Truth and Public Welfare.
Your group is pushing government to lift the ban, the total ban on dengue vaccine.
Yes. Well, our statement says that we urge government to be open to lifting the ban on dengue vaccine, which is the dengue vaccine available, and to make it available to those who want it and those who need it. Given the appropriate indications and the appropriate advice on how to use it, mm-hmm. which includes as much as possible to make sure that the patient has had a previous dengue infection.
That's the element we're adding now.
Yes, yes,
versus
right.
the previous time that we've done.
Correct, yes.
But then you say that maybe you and I have been infected, we're mm-hmm. not even aware.
That's right. I think the part of the decision was based on the fact that majority of us after the age of 9 have had dengue infection. Mm-hmm. And the risk of getting a more severe dengue infection in those who are vaccinated who have never had dengue is actually the same as the risk of those who get another dengue mm-hmm. infection after they have had a first one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
essentially,
it's the same. Mm-hmm.
So essentially, doctor, what you want is for the private sector to have the option.
Yes, for all of us to have the option.
But
yes,
it's not necessarily going to be part of government's immunization
not
program.
Necessarily.
So not
that
free.
Is government's call.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that is government's call, whether they want to put it back into their immunization program or not. And generally, if it is a government project like mm-hmm. that, it is given free to the public.
Mm-hmm.
When it is made available to the private sector, then the people who will want the dengue vaccine are going to have to pay for the vaccine and for the services of the private physician.
Mm-hmm. And just for a context, doctor, how much would this vaccine be? A ballpark figure?
Possibly? I'm not sure anymore. I remember the figure 3,000 pesos, mm-hmm. but I don't know if that is for the total course of 3 injections mm-hmm. every 6 months mm-hmm. or whether that is just for 1 injection.
Mm-hmm. But other countries are using the same vaccine. Singapore, for example.
Oh, yes, yes. 21 countries and 28 countries within the European Union, because in Europe it is approved for use. In the United States, it is approved for use in areas of high dengue endemicity. In 20 other countries, it is approved for use also, and they are using it. Mm-hmm. In Brazil, for example, it is given in a mass vaccination program.
Mm-hmm. And just to clarify, for those watching, Dengvaxia is not a shot that you get while you have dengue. It doesn't cure your dengue today.
No, it does not cure your dengue. But it will prevent you from having another bout of dengue mm-hmm. or will reduce the severity of the next bout of dengue if you ever have one.
Mm-hmm. And in your over 50 years of experience as a doctor and your stint as health secretary before, have you come across a similar controversy as a Dengvaxia?
Yes, for now, the vaccine controversy is still raging. There is a group of people that we call the anti-vaxxers mm-hmm. who think that all vaccines are bad, which is totally against the evidences that we have. And then, for example, any kind of drug like cholesterol medicines, there is also a controversy on that, right? Mm-hmm. The scientists think that cholesterol medicines that will lower cholesterol levels will reduce your chances of getting heart disease and strokes and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But there is a group of people who warn against the use of cholesterol medicines, who say that it is bad for your liver and bad for your kidneys and stuff like that. The truth is, for all medicines, there has to be an analysis of cost and benefit. And if we think that the advantages outweigh the disadvantages, then we decide to use that kind of medicine. Because, and if not, no.
Because, doctor, there seems to be perception, you know, distrust yes. against the pharma industry. You know, some people joke, you know, pharma companies, it's a business at the end of the day. They
yes,
want to keep you
right.
well,
yes.
just well enough, mm-hmm. but something that will keep you coming back for more. So that's basically the cost-benefit is what you recommend to your patients at least.
Absolutely,
always.
Yes. The doctors must be open to their patients, tell them what are the advantages and disadvantages, mm-hmm. and together they can decide whether it is good to use it or not.
And for those who are wondering, you're not vaccinated with Dengvaxia?
No, because I'm too old.
Okay, because the age for the Dengvaxia shot is from what age to what age?
9 to 45.
Okay, so for those watching.
I'm 46.
You just turned 46,
yes.
I heard. Thank you very much, Dr. Cabral,
thank
for joining
you,
us
thank
for clarifying
you very
the
much.
Issue.
Thank you.
To watch more ANC videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the bell button for more updates.